What's happening, YouTube and all my new subscribers? I hope you're having a fantastic day. I know I am. So today what we're doing is I'm preparing the new tank I have downstairs with the products that I mentioned in my Substrate special before. Now this is the organic potting soil, and the last time I did this, I didn't record, but I want to show some of the things that you may find inside your organic soil whenever you're preparing it for a tank that you'll definitely want to get rid of. I've only gone through a couple pounds of it so far, but like, I mean, right here, there is an actual plant growing in there. I have, you know, no idea what kind of plant it is, but it's not the only one I found. I saved it, you know, but I mean, I'm not sure what the consequences of that would be, you know, having some wild plant growing underwater, you know, in there, but I feel it should have been taken out. So, I mean, it's going to rot anyway for sure. And the rest of this, these like large clumps here, you're going to find a lot of this. This is just actually like a branch from a tree, you know, twigs. These aren't going to do you know, any good. But however, you know, I wish I had saved one. You will find pebbles in there, and you don't have to remove those. And let me explain why. Little pebbles and rocks are something that I would mix in a soil substrate like this anyway if it didn't already come with it. And the reason for that is that it does several things. It helps with the gas exchange, for one thing, and makes room for roots, you know, to part their way through. It can also give some of them something to cling on to. But a lot of it just has to do with gas exchange. You don't want your soil so compacted that it's, you know, difficult for your plants to root themselves through. Now, because remember, this is different than, you know, gardening outside. This stuff is going to be saturated and weighted down with water, you know, so you need to make the substrate as easy as you possibly can for the roots to start growing through it. Now I have to make a couple more because I'm doing a three-part section of all these substrates, and then I got to figure out how to combine them all. But yeah, I'm using this. I'm just kind of, you know, sifting through it in here and then finding the large clumps, live plants, large sticks. I'm only leaving the soil. You will find random dead roots. Those are okay to leave. That's part of it. Most of your organic substrate is going to have manure and roots from plants, peat moss, you know, those sorts of things. Now I'm pouring. This is purified water. I don't use my tap water anymore, and if you want to know why, you'll find it in one of my videos. But for me, tap water is just a huge no-no. I mean, even if you're getting well water, or if you're getting water that's, you know, fed from a spring or whatever that's filled with a lot of minerals and nutrients, you don't know what kind of pipes are running through underground. And, you know, if it's collecting rust and dumping that into your water, or copper that can kill shrimp if you're a shrimp keeper. You know, a lot of our pipes that run through softeners will start dumping tons of copper and rust and things that you don't want. So anyway, purified water is what I'm mixing in there. I don't need any nutrient rich water of any kind. This, if I were to put my TDS meter in here, it would say zero, because there's absolutely nothing in this. It's straight purified water, the same as roadie water. Except what I do like about purified water over roadie water is that it takes a lot more energy to do reverse osmosis on water than when you buy purified water. And I got in an argument with someone. I don't know why I made a Facebook. I got on there and I joined a couple groups thinking it'd be fun to talk about stuff. And this woman seemed to think she knows everything about water. And she's like, I can't use my water on my plants because it goes through a softener and all that sodium is bad for your plants. Well, yeah, no shit. And she goes, well, and I said, so she goes, so where can I get a roadie unit fast and quick? And I was like, well, if you can't find an RO unit right now, the best thing to do is to get purified water. And she was like, "Ha ha, you're stupid." And I was like, "How so? And why the hell are you talking to me that way?" And she's like, "Because purified water goes through softeners." And I was like, "No, it does not. It does not go through softeners. It's not filtered the same way it is in your house." And I was like, "I'll prove it to you right now." So then I made a video, opened up a brand new bottle of purified water, not distilled. There is a difference between distilled and purified, but we can talk about that later. But purified is better. I opened it up, poured it in there, stuck my TDS meter in there, and you know, total dissolved solids, and said, "See, zero." Now, if this had gone through a softener, it would read this. And I had my tap water that does go through a softener, and it read 300. And she was like, "Whatever, playing camera tricks on me." And I was like, "I'm not going to talk to idiots. Whatever, I'm out of here." So, but anyway, yeah, I'm using purified water. We're going to mix all this. Now, when you're mixing your organic soil and you dump water in, you don't want it to be soup, okay? I mean, like right now, it's kind of soft to the touch already. See how I can kind of form a ball? I don't want it much more drenched than what it already is. So I've only got a couple gallons here, and I'm going to put about an inch of this at the bottom of my 40-gallon breeder. So, you know, if you see that it's, you know, the water ratio is way too much, add more soil, because you also don't want it too runny, like really thick mud. You just, a little bit softer than this with some actual water. And I do it out here, and I have seen people who do it in their tank, and I don't do that. You're going to get soil and dirt all over the side of the glass and, you know, everything else. So I mix it in here, then I'll dump it in the tank. So anyway, in goes my purified water. All right, here comes the nasty stuff. All right, yeah. Yeah, you're going to have to get your hands wet. You bought some fish and you think you're not going to ever have to get your hands wet or dirty. You're tripping balls. All right, and here we go. Actually, I put just enough. This is perfect. See, whenever I squeeze it, there shouldn't be a bunch of water running out of it. It should still be able to hold its shape. So I've got a perfect consistency here now with this, and I'm going to go dump it into my tank and see how, I only want about an inch of this, and then we'll go from there. All right. Thanks for watching. Ooh, manure. That's cow shit for some of you who don't know. Ooh, let me smell my hands. Ooh, nice. Ooh, cow shit smells nice. Oh, sweet. All right. Thanks for watching. Have a good day.